In the day's other news, the surge of COVID infections in much of the world has hit new highs, a record 292,000 cases just in the last 24 hours. India alone reported 55,000 cases, its most yet. Meanwhile, Britain's Prime Minister Boris Johnson abruptly imposed new restrictions in northern England. And in Vietnam, thousands were tested after an outbreak in Da Nang, now under a lockdown. Hanoi and other cities also report new infections. A storm that battered Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic is now Hurricane Isaias, and it is heading for the U.S. East Coast. It swept over the Bahamas today and was expected to strengthen before reaching South Florida this weekend and the Carolinas by Monday. A hurricane warning is now up for Florida's Atlantic coast. Hong Kong today postponed September's legislative elections by a year, citing the pandemic's ongoing resurgence. It was a setback for pro-democracy forces who hope for an overwhelming win at the polls. Activist Joshua Wong said it's all part of a campaign, including barring him and others from running for the city legislature.
Beijing has staged multiple acts to prevent the opposition bloc from taking the majority in Hong Kong legislature. Our voice is clear and loud to the world by our vote. We stand to defend our freedom and right that's stipulated in the Joint Declaration and the Basic Law.
The election delay comes as mainland China is moving to curb dissent in Hong Kong under a new national security law. Back in this country, a 17-year-old boy in Tampa, Florida, was charged today in a major hack of Twitter this month. Investigators said that he sent bogus tweets from high-profile figures, including Barack Obama, Joe Biden, Bill Gates, and others. The tweets promoted a Bitcoin scam that netted more than $100,000. Two other suspects, one in Britain and one in Orlando, Florida, are also charged. A federal appeals court has overturned the death sentence of Dzhokar Tsarnaev. He's the convicted Boston Marathon bomber. Today's ruling said the jurors were not sufficiently vetted for bias. Tsarnaev and his older brother carried out the 2013 attack that killed three people and injured 260. The brother died in a gun battle with police. U.S. Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg was discharged from a hospital in New York today. She had a procedure on a bile duct stent. Ginsburg is 87 and is also being treated for a recurrence of cancer. The U.S. Census Bureau is moving its deadline for this year's count back to the original date, December 31st. Officials wanted an extension through next April due to pandemic delays, but the request has stalled in Congress. Civil rights and other groups warned that the December timetable means an undercount that will hurt minorities. Census results affect congressional districts and the distribution of federal funds. And on Wall Street, despite yesterday's grim second quarter economic report, tech stocks led a late rally to close out a fourth straight month of market gains. The Dow Jones Industrial Average was up 114 points to close at 26,428. The NASDAQ rose 157 points, and the S&P 500 added nearly 25. Still to come on the NewsHour, the Assistant Attorney General for National Security discusses the state of U.S.-China relations. Who are the women Joe Biden is considering to be his running mate as the campaign for the White House heats up? Mark Shields and David Brooks look behind the week's myriad political headlines, plus much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.